Now, my dear brothers and sisters, before I begin the fiqh discussion, I need to say, as I've said many times before, all of you should be aware there are four schools of Sunni law: the Shafi'is, the Hanbalis, the Hanafis, the Malikis. And all of these schools of law are legitimate, and we should not cause any division or criticize any of these. All of these are legitimate expressions. So if you wish to stick to your school of law, alhamdulillah, no problem with that. And if you wish to ask somebody what his or her position is, and you wish to follow that position, that too is acceptable. With that disclaimer, realize that the issue of reciting Fatiha, there are some areas where all scholars are agreed. If you're praying by yourself, then by all of the madhahib, you must recite Fatiha in every rak'ah. You cannot have a salah without reciting Fatiha in every single rak'ah. And this is based upon the authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, La salata liman lam yaqra bi umm al-kitab aw bi Fatiha al-kitab. Explicit hadith. There is no salah, la salah. There is no salah for the one who does not recite the Fatiha. So, all of the madhahib agree that if you are praying by yourself or you are the imam of a congregation, that you must recite Fatiha in every single rak'ah of every single salah. Fard salah, sunnah salah, nafil salah, the salah of shukr, the salah of rain, the salah of fear, the salah of Eid, every type of salah, the salah of janazah, you must recite Fatiha as well, because it is a salah. So every salah that we pray, we read Surah Al-Fatiha in the salah. So what is the controversy then? The huge controversy that exists from the time of the Sahaba, it's nothing new, goes back to the Sahaba themselves. Some companions held one view, other companions held another view. So this ikhtilaf has been going on for 14 centuries. What is the controversy? When you are behind the imam right now, you are praying behind an imam. Now what should you do? This is the area of controversy. Not when you're praying by yourself, not when you are the imam. When you're praying behind the imam, what should you do? There's a number of opinions. Very simplistically, the Hanafi school of law says that at any instance, whether the imam is reciting out loud or quietly, you do not recite Fatiha. So the Hanafi position is the one behind the imam does not recite Fatiha in any circumstance whatsoever. On the exact other side of the spectrum, you have the Shafi'i school. And the Shafi'i school says, you must recite Fatiha in every salah behind the imam. And this is not the Shafi'i position, this is the position of the Zahiri Madhab, it's the position of Abu Huraira the companion, and other of the Sahaba as well, that you need to recite the Fatiha in every single rak'ah, whether the imam is out loud, such as right now in Isha, in Fajr, or the imam is silent, such as Dhuhr and Asr, you must recite Fatiha. This is the Shafi'i position. So this is the two extremes on the one side. Then you have the middle position. So you have the Hanafi position on the one side, never recite. You have the Shafi'i position on the other side, recite every time. Then you have the Maliki and the Hanbali position in the middle. And that is, in the quiet prayers you recite. What are the quiet prayers? Dhuhr and Asr. And also the quiet rak'ahs, right? So the last two rak'ahs of Isha. And the loud prayers, when you're hearing the imam, you don't recite. So this position basically says, if you can hear the imam recite Fatiha, then his recitation counts for your recitation. And this position is the majority position, and they base it on many evidences of them, is that the Quran says, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا. When the Quran is recited, then listen to it and be quiet, so that Allah can have mercy on you. And Imam Ahmad says, this verse was revealed because the Sahaba were reciting in the prayer, so Allah revealed this verse. So he makes a tafsir of this verse. This verse applies to the salah. وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا. Also, there's an authentic hadith, Bukhari and Muslim, that our Prophet ﷺ said, the imam has been made to be followed. إِنَّمَا جُعْلَ الْإِمَامُ لِيُؤْتَمَّ بِهِ. The imam has been made to be followed. So when he says Allahu Akbar, you say Allahu Akbar. And when he recites, you listen. And when he goes into ruku', you go into ruku', and the hadith goes on all the way. But when he recites, what should you do? وَإِذَا قَرَأَ فَأَنصِتُوا. This hadith is authentic, it's in Sahih Muslim. When he recites, you be quiet and you listen to that. And also, they base this on other evidences as well, of them being that, how can a person behind the imam recite when the imam is reciting? How can the person behind the imam recite when the imam is reciting? Either he misses the second portion of the recitation or whatnot. So this is the majority position. It is also the position of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala. And also they say that the whole point of saying Ameen, the whole point of saying Ameen, when the imam finishes Fatiha, what do? We say Ameen. Ibn Kathir and others, they say, when you say Ameen, it is as if you have done the Fatiha as well. Because that's the whole point of saying Ameen. That, oh Allah, me too. I want this as well. So this is the stamp as well. In any case, as I said at the beginning of this talk, whatever position you follow, alhamdulillah, these positions have been around for 14 centuries. So if you want to follow the Hanafi position, the Shafi'i position, the Maliki or the Hanbali position, all of this, inshaAllah ta'ala, is legitimate. So my dear brothers and sisters, my parting advice to myself and all of you, don't trivialize this surah. Don't zoom through it at supersonic speed. Don't just recite it like a hummingbird buzzing away like the bees. This is a surah that Allah chose. This is a surah that an angel came down and Jibreel was with the Prophet ﷺ, and the angel said that I have never come down to earth. This is the first time I'm coming down, and Allah has sent me to tell you that no prophet has ever gotten a surah like this surah. This is that surah, a blessing that our Prophet Muhammad ﷺ has been given. It is a blessing for our ummah. So let us not trivialize this surah. Let us appreciate the surah. Let us understand it. Let us be amazed at its profundity. Let us appreciate the beauty. And most importantly, let us recite it sincerely from the heart. Perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our dua. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een. Ihdina al-sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-lazina an'amta alayhim. Ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim. Wala al-dallin. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'awan. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.